Hey guys, how you doing? JP Saricolia here. Now, when you think about Royal Selangor, you think about one of the most important, if not the biggest, pewter company in the world. And when it comes about producing some of the most fine art collectibles based or created in pewter, I don't think there's other company as important as Royal Selangor. Of course, there's other companies in different parts of the world, but Royal Selangor, it's a standard for a lot of collectors, a standard for people that are looking for the best of the best. They have some new statues for sale at SciShow. SciShow distributes in North America, and we're gonna look at them because they look fantastic. As soon as I saw them, I didn't get a chance to talk about them, but I was thinking about it for quite some time. So now is the chance, today is the day, and we're gonna cover this magnificent statues. Now, as you can see, we have a whole classic cover. There are three different versions. You get a gilt edition, which is the golden edition. You get a green edition. You get a satin, which technically is the more metallic type. You also get Spider-Man based on Amazing Fantasy number 15. You get the satin, the metallic one, and you also get the golden type. And this is on the wait list now, but you can find it in some other retailers. And we also have a Darth Vader. It's a golden, there's the silver one, and the black pewter. Now, there are differences in price. In this case, the gilt edition, the golden edition, this one is $780, but it's only limited to 200. It's almost sold out at SciShow, so keep an eye on that. The estimated arrival for this is between February and April of 2021, which is really soon, just to think about it. Time flies. But when you look at this piece, I love the golden style. Not necessarily a fan of the black and white background, particularly with this covers, but it's cool. It's not bad at all. I love the detail on this one. Love the gold. I think the golden, the gilt one, gives us more definition with the shading that is natural to this material. It looks great. I like it. If you want the most expensive, the most sold out, the most collectible one, definitely this is the one. All right, now we're looking at the green editions, and the price for this one is $650. Now, with all of this, there is also a layaway payment plan that is offered by SciShow, which is always good news. The estimated arrival is the same as the other one. It's limited to only 300, so you get 100 more, still very small number. And looking at this, actually, this is not bad. If you really want, in this case, Hulk to look like Hulk in green color, then definitely this is another option. It's a matter of choice. It's the same background, the same base you get in the back of the comic book, in addition size information, all of that. That really works. To me, this is a very nice, I don't know what to tell you. I like them all. I like this green for sure. It's really, really nice. I like it. I like it, the overall design, and it's a beautiful piece of art. Okay, and now we're looking at the one that I personally like the most, because I like at least the base on this one. This is the satin version. The edition size for this is 500, which is a small number in comparison to the rest. It's $500. Also, there's a layaway plan, and the estimated arrival is the same as the other one. Now, for those who are unfamiliar, the cover of this comic book in the background is based on the Marvel Treasury edition number 5. This is a 1975 comic book, and I like the colors. And to be honest with you, if I could kind of change things around, I will actually add the green Hulk on this one, and that will be perfect in my opinion. That will be the perfect Hulk for this edition in my opinion. Of course, you know, they want to sell more, so they have to kind of switch around some of the colors. So it's just a matter of preference. I know that some collectors, you know, they are able and they will get all of them, and more power to them for doing so. But if I have the power to change something, that would be the case. I love the comic book. It is still a very nice pewter statue. I just like the, I don't know, I can change the color. I will add the green one to this one. And as you can see with the, in this case, the gilt one and then the green one, you can see more of the effect of the shading because of the material, because of the colors. But in this case, you see it, but not as detailed as much. It's not as pronounced as with the other two. All right, and now we're moving on to Spider-Man Amazing Fantasy number 15, of course, based on the iconic cover. This one, in this case, the gilt version, the golden version, is limited to only 200. It's $780. That's the price. And this one is already, well, sold out for the time being. So, but you can join the wait list at SciShow. The estimated arrival for this is between February and March of 2021, the same as Hulk. I really like this one. This is a very nice Spider-Man. Love the gilt version. As you can see with the gilt, you can see more of the colors. And I love that they have the difference here with the, in this case, the spiderweb is different. This is a more modern spiderweb. And in this case, the person that he's carrying with him, as in the comic cover, is a different material. In this case, different color. So the pronunciation here is, of course, on Spider-Man. And I really love what they did here. And I love, actually, you see the Spider-Man symbol on the base. That is super, super cool. At every angle, this is a very nice piece. Definitely, this is a very classy depiction of Spider-Man, and I love it. The satin version, the metallic version, and the edition size for this is 800. It's higher, but still not as bad. The price is $500. Now, people will say, why is it that this is so expensive being so small? Remember, pewter, it's a material that it really requires a lot of good craftsmanship. Only a few craftsmen in the world are able to produce high-quality pewter collectibles and statues. And this is not your average 3D model done and then printed in some type of printing machine, 3D printer. This is done in a shop that specializes in producing pewter collectibles, and those are becoming extremely rare. And of course, Royal Selangor is still one of the best, if not the biggest company right now in the world that produces this kind of stuff. They sell in some of the biggest stores in the world, the best stores in the world, the most specialized or the most sold out stores. You will find Royal Selangor stuff. Now, I love the cover. Again, the same thing as I did with Hulk. I love this color covers. It's super nice. And actually, it doesn't look bad with this one. Everything is pretty much in satin. The only, this gentleman is, of course, is darker, but everything else is the same. So there's a difference. I don't know. I think this one is fine as it is. I don't know how the gold one will look with this one, with the background maybe gets lost there. I like this one. I feel that this one is perfect as it is, and it doesn't need any changes. If I get it, it would be this one. I'll be honest with you. And I love the whole detail that they have done with this one. Definitely, it's super, super cool. Well done. Okay, now we're moving from Marvel to Star Wars. We're going to start with Darth Vader Buzz, the gilt version, the golden version. It's only limited to 300 pieces. Very, very limited. $700. Of course, this is not for the faint of heart. This is for those who have the means to pay for something so small this much money. And the estimated arrival is between January and March. So it's just around the corner. I like this one. Man, it's super cool. You know, in this case, the base, if I'm not mistaken, is made out of polystone or some type of heavy resin. It has probably some type of weight in it. But in this case, Darth Vader is really well done. Love the golden version. This gilt version looks great. And I think it will shine on any display. Now, we're looking at the Black Bus. And this one, is the edition size is limited to 500 pieces, and it's $600. That's the price for this one, the same estimated arrival date. That will be, in my opinion, another great choice. Of course, Darth Vader is black, so the whole armor is black. So I think this is very fitting with the character. So if I would say you miss on the golden version, then this is the second best choice, in my opinion. Really like the way Zahn is the same piece as the other one. The only, of course, the difference is the color in this case in the pewter, but beyond that, it's just the same sculpt, nothing more, nothing less. And finally, we're looking at the poor man's version, if you can say that. This is $475, which still pretty steep, but yeah, if you know, thinking about this size of these pieces, then maybe this is the one that most people can afford. Doesn't even have an edition size. I don't know how many they're gonna produce. It doesn't say. And the same estimated arrival date as the other ones. You can choose the layaway plan. Now, this one is not bad. You come to think of it, looking at it, it's not a really bad choice. It's very shiny, and that's good. I love the gilt version. I think the black version is very good too. And this one, of course, depending on the conditions, on the lighting, all of that, it might even look kind of black, or, you know, it can shine more depending on the surface where you display it. It is a really nice choice. I'm telling you this. These are very nice pieces. Royal Selangor is a company that is doing such amazing work. It's easy to dismiss some things based on scale. I feel that a lot of collectors, they think about scale as the thing that determines the price, and it's not so. There are a lot of factors, and one of them is material and craftsmanship. Now, there's less pewter craftsmen in the world, and when you have this type of collectibles that have been pretty much among us forever, even before polystone resin was used, it really reminds us of, you know, how far we have come in this, pretty much in this hobby, in this industry. And I think pewter steel is a viable material, very powerful, very collectible, very sought out. You know, many statues lose price over time, over the years, materials, you know, deteriorate, particularly with mixed media and all of that. But pewter is pretty much made to last. And you know, it'll be 100 years from now, 200 years from now, you will see pewter statues out there. And polystone, we don't know, they will last more than 20 years, 30 years. Sometimes they don't even last that long. So that really gives us an idea of the quality of these collectibles, that they're made to last. And definitely that's reflected in the price. Now, what do you think about these? Are you excited for them? Have you pre-ordered? Are you going to pre-order? Do you think they're too expensive? They're not for you? Let me know in the comments below. So once again, my friends, thanks for watching. God bless. Take care. And I'll talk to you again. Bye-bye.